mighty, mighty proud to be associated with such a group of fighters. Okay?
The past inspires the future, so it needs to be preserved.
It's a treat for your players to go back and show their kids and maybe even show their grandkids at this point that, yeah, old dad or old granddad, that's me out there, number 54 out there on that field, running around, making tackles, getting hit, running the ball.
The Terrapins' football glory spans decades, and the University of Maryland is working hard to preserve the film it's captured on.
It's not just what happened this week, this year, or even in the last couple of years, but what has happened over the last 100 years.
There's a play where Paul Villano grabs a guy by his jersey and basically shakes him around like a rag doll. Well, we've seen stills of that, and now we actually get to see the live action.
Highlights from the 60s and 70s, even classic games, like the first game at Byrd Stadium, they're all being digitized and placed in the university archives. The legacy helps define the culture and spirit of Maryland athletics. Now, the Football Archive Project is helping former players share their memories.
I mean, this is the first time that they've been able to see that film, in many cases, since the days that they played here. They're now also going to be able to share it with their wives, with their children, and with their grandchildren. And so it's a very emotional thing for a lot of them.
Thanks to the Archive Project, students, fans, and alumni can search online and find the game that even the Queen of England attended.
Program. And a queen in person makes a triumphal entry into a football stadium. A sellout crowd of 43,000 cheers Queen Elizabeth.
About 400 reels of game footage and film have been rescued from chemical deterioration. But the Archives is missing a number of games, so it's reaching out to the community in order to build the collection.
One of the big holes in our video and our film record for Maryland football is the 1953 National Championship season. We have no game footage at all from that season.
It's strange how many people have them. They're not all football players that have films. Fans have them, friends have them. People may have videotaped a game or a highlight film or a bowl game. If you've got old film of games, either videotape or regular film of games, contact the University Archives Department, and they will not only take your film gladly, they will copy it for you, put it on a DVD, and give you that DVD back. So not only have you contributed, but now you've got the film in a format that you can watch every day.
The university hopes to raise another $20,000 to complete the digitization of all its film between 1946 and 1989. To contribute to the project, contact the University Archives for more information.